This video is about how to use my jetting calculator to tune a Dellorto carburetor. This is the calculator, and it is a Excel spreadsheet, and it takes in all the information to compose this graph right here. And the red graph is showing whether or not you're high or low from 1/8 slide open all the way to wide open throttle. High or low in regards to what is considered perfect. And the blue graph is the actual jetting richness, which shows it a little bit rich to begin with, which is typical. So, my website is right here. And this page shows the actual effects, the different changes of the different components in the carburetor. As you can see, the needle does not just affect the mid-range, it also affects the top end, the full wide open throttle setting. And the main jet does not just affect the wide open throttle setting, it also has an effect at closed throttle. So that is important to know. This is the universal system that I use to input the needed data into the calculator as far as how far the slide is open. Well, actually, for the different slide opening positions, where that needle is in relation to the needle jet. So if you put a dot at the beginning of the needle taper with marks a lot, and then insert it into the slide, insert it into the carb, and move it up and down until that dot is like right at the top of the needle jet. Then you put a dot on the slide and you measure that distance right there and you subtract it from the distance from the carb bore size. So on mine it was like 12.5 millimeters and the carb is 18. So the difference right here is, 5.5 millimeters. So that amount goes right here. And I'm going to show you how it affects the tuning. Right now I want it to be richer, so I'm going to make that smaller. Yeah, you see how this is the 1.0 line, that's the ideal. And now up to about half throttle, it's above the ideal. So it made that section richer. It also brought this up a little bit higher. And then, of course, the opposite is true. When you raise it, you lower that portion of the jetting graph. So I'm going to show you a short video right now, showing the process of me measuring for the beginning of that taper, putting a mark there, and then putting it into the carburetor, and then eyeballing it from this direction here. And when that's there, I put a mark there and then measure that. So let's take a look at that now.
Yo quiero hacer a ella el de caballo.
attention.
Rivera, el punto negro?
Sí, lo veo.
Okay.
Okay, now that you understand that, the only other strangeness is measuring the height of the needle shroud. Some carbs have it and some don't. The needle shroud captures more of the vacuum wave coming from the engine. So with a needle shroud, you have smaller main jet and less area between the needle and the needle jet. So, yeah. Right here is the distance of the needle shroud height. All the cells in light blue are data entry cells. And I need to show you about this. The bottom here is four tabs. So the idle jet goes right here. The main jet goes right here. The needle jet ID goes right here. And the program reads the first three numbers and divides that by 100 to give the needle jet hole diameter, which it shows right here. You put the needle ID right here, but that's only for your reference. The program doesn't do anything with that. You have to tell it the dimensions of the needle down here, which with Dellorto, they use the same dimensions. So a single taper will have dimensions A, B, and C. A dual taper will have A through E. And a triple taper will have A through G. So if you look on my site, it has a listing of all the Dellorto needles. So the needle is usually stamped on the needle right here. So just look it up and then take note of A, B, C. They give D also on this one, but it's not used in the program, so just A, B, and C. Down here, you've got a few that go through A through E, and then there's a very few that go through G. There's three of them. So you take that data, and you put it right here. A, B, C, D, E, F, G. This is a dual taper because it goes to E. So then, using that information, the program will calculate the needle diameter alongside the top of the needle jet for all the different slide positions. And using that, it's able to graph the needle jetting. So one other strange thing about Dellorto is that when it says the slide is 40, that means its cutaway height is 4.5 millimeters. When it says it's 50, it means it's 5.75 millimeters. And I think 30 is 3.25. Yeah. So anyway, yeah, you just enter the information and you look and see what it's like. Maybe you want to try a different needle, you put the different needle information here. If the beginning of this is too high or too low, you change the height right here. And the most important of the whole thing is right around here, the last portion. That being as close as possible to 1.0 is important. And I think that's about it. So just check out my website and go for it. There's nothing like having a really well-tuned carburetor. And I don't care how experienced you are, you cannot tell me exactly what that carb's doing as well as a jetting calculator can. I know, because I've dealt with tuning carbs for many years, and I was still baffled in some instances, and all the baffling has gone right out the window using the jetting calculator. It tells me exactly what's happening. Okay, my friend, thanks for watching. Take care.